How's it going, everyone? My name is Miguel Fuentes, and I am the campus pastor at Freedom Campus at, what's it called? On the Project Connect Online Church Facebook page or Facebook group. And so I am very, very excited for this sermon. I don't know about you. I'm glad I'm taking this Memorial Day break just to seek the Lord what he wants me to do and all. And so we're gonna get into 1 Corinthians chapter 12 and 13, and then next week we'll finish the rest. And yeah, so before we get started, let's go ahead and pray first. Heavenly Father, Lord, we just thank you, Lord, for today, Lord. Lord, you're so awesome. You're so amazing, God. God, I pray that you give me patience, Lord. And Father, I ask that you would give me strategies, Lord, to defeat the enemy, Lord. And Father, I ask that you would come and change my heart, change my ways, Lord. And I pray that, Lord, I plead the blood of Jesus over my heart, my life, my mind. And Lord, I pray that let this be a Holy Spirit-led sermon, Lord. I pray that there would be lots of convictions, a lot of repenting. And I thank you so much, God, for all that you've done. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. So before I get started, let's go ahead and drink some water. So let's go ahead and turn with me on 1 Corinthians chapter 12. And I'm reading out of the Eastern Standard Version today. Are you there? All right, let's get to it. And it reads, Now concerning spiritual gifts. Brothers, I do not want you to be uninformed. You know that when you were pagans, you were led astray to mute idols. However, you were led. Therefore, I want you to understand that no one speaking in the Spirit of God ever say Jesus is a curse. And no one can say Jesus is Lord except in the Holy Spirit. Very powerful statement. Now there are various of gifts, but the same Spirit. And there are various of service, but the same Lord. And there are various of activities, but it is the same God who empowers them all and everyone. To each is given the manifestation of the Spirit for the common good. For to one is given through the Spirit, the utterance of wisdom, and to another, the utterance of knowledge, according to the same Spirit. To another, faith by the same Spirit. To another, gifts of healing by the one Spirit. To another, the working of miracles. To another, prophecy. to another the ability to distinguish between spirits, and to another various kinds of tongues, and to another the interpretation of tongues. All these are empowered by one and the same Spirit, who appreciates to each one individually as he wills. Didn't read that right. For just as the body is one, and has many members, and all the members of the body through many are one body, so it is with Christ. For in one Spirit we were all baptized into one body, Jews or Greeks, slaves or free, and all we were made to drink of one Spirit. For the body does not contain one member, but of many. If the foot should say, because I am not a hand, I am not belong to the body, that would not make it any less a part of a body. And if the ear should say, because I am not an eye, I do not belong to the body, that would not make it any less a part of the body. If the whole body were an eye, where would be the senses of hearing? If the whole body were an ear, where would be the senses of smell? But as it is, God arranged the members in the body, each one of them as he chose. If all were a single member, where were the body be? Excuse me. As it is, there are many parts, yet one body. The eye cannot say to the hand, I have no need of you, nor again the head to the foot, I have no need of you. On the contrary, the parts of the body that seem to be weaker are indispensable, and on those parts of the body that were think less honorable, we bestow the greater honor. And our unpresentable parts are treated with great modesty. Which our more presentable parts do not require. But God has so comprised the body, given greater honor to the part that lacks it, that there may be no division in the body, but that the members may have the same care for one another. If one member suffers, all suffer together. If one body is honored, all rejoice together. And I'm froze. Okay. Now you are the body of Christ, and individually members of it. And God has appointed in the church first apostles, second prophets, third teachers, then miracles, then gifts of healing, helping, administration, and various kinds of tongues. Are all apostles? Are all prophets? Are all teachers? Are all work miracles? Do all possess gifts of healing? Do all speak with tongues? Do all interpret? But earnestly desire the higher gifts, and I will show you a still more excellent way. Interesting. Let's go ahead and read chapter 13. If I speak in the tongue of men and of angels, but have not love, I am a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. And if I have prophetic powers and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have all faith so as to remove mountains, but I have not love, I am nothing. If I give away all I have, and if I deliver up my body to be burned, but have not love, I gain nothing. Love is patient and kind. Love does not envy or boast it. It is not ignorant or rude. It does not intend on its own way. It is not irascible or resentful. It does not rejoice at wrongdoing, but rejoices with the truth. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends. As for prophecy, they will pass away. As for tongues, they will cease. As for knowledge, it will pass away. For we know in part, and we prophesy in part. But when the perfect comes, the partial will pass away. When I was a child, I speak like a child. I thought like a child. I reasoned like a child. When I became a man, I grew up. I gave up childish ways. For now we see in a mirror, dimly, but then face to face. Now I know in part. Then I shall know fully, even as I have been fully known. So now faith, hope, and love abide, these three. But the greatest of these is love. I'm going to repeat that. So now, faith, hope, and love abide, these three. But the greatest of these is love. Thank you, Lord, for your word, Lord. So, what do we have here? In chapter 12, we see that the Apostle Paul laid out the spiritual gifts. And it also talks about being one body with many members. And in chapter 13, he focuses on love. So here are the life lessons. So number one, there is order in using spiritual gifts. Meaning, the Apostle Paul laid out every gifts that Paul was speaking. We use it in a orderly fashion. It never meant to be out of order. If we serve a God that is in order. And so I did some research. And there are probably at least 18 to 21 spiritual gifts that the scripture talks about. And the first thing is called the ministry gifts. You got the gift of, or the office and the gift of apostleship, prophets, pastors, teachers, and helpers. Number two, we have the manifestation gifts, like the discernment of spirits, evangelism, faith, healing, interpretation of tongues, word of knowledge, miracles, word of wisdom, prophecy, speaking in tongues. And lastly, we have the what's called the motivational gifts, such as the gift of administration or governing, the gift of exhortation, the gift of giving, the gift of mercy or helps, the gift of leadership, the gift of serving, the gift of teaching as well. And second point I want to make is that in order to function the gifts is to love. Love is everything. Because I understand that when I don't love, not only the Holy Spirit will convict me, it will hurt inside of me. Because it is my responsibility as pastor to love everybody. Now, understand, yes, I hate their sin, but we still gotta love. We gotta speak the truth in love. It's very, very important that without the love, the gifts are useless. Without the love, the gifts are really useless. And I've seen a lot of, there's a lot of prophets out there. They start prophesying. But where's the love? Where's the love? And I understand, yes, the devil and demonic spirits can counterfeit these gifts as psychics, mediums, necromancy. These are all counterfeits. But that's what the discernment of spirit is. They discern whether this is from the good guy or discernment that maybe these are the bad guys. That gift is powerful, in my opinion. And we should know the difference between the good guys, the kingdom of God, and the bad guys, the kingdom of Satan. And Paul mentioned this, that we need to seek the higher gifts, which we'll get into chapter 14, 15, and 16 next week. But I understand that demons and devils hate love, because love is the worst acid to them. And so when we love, when we prophesy with love, not only that somebody will get free, but somebody will know that your deliverance is now, that your breakthrough is coming your way. There's the difference between the gift of prophecy and the office of the prophet. And I know the difference. Because I met, my life coach, Israel Johnson. I knew for a fact that he holds the office of a prophet. A lot of things started fulfilling his prophecy. Because he don't play. Because these things are going to happen. And I know for a fact that he said, I think on that live, on that last live stream, he said that this summer is going to be the bloodiest summer that you'll ever see. There will be more massive shootings in America like never before. And you know what I did? I took his word for it. Because whatever he says is true. I have faith that it will come to pass. And number three, there is no such thing as preaching too much of the love of God. Now, I understand, yes, we should balance. There is a balance of who God is. Yes, God is love, and we should love too. God is the judge, and we judge righteously. God is the truth, and Jesus says the truth will set you free. He is the mercy of God, and God gave us mercy when we fall, when we stumble. God is my provider. He provide a way for me to have, you know, to have food in my belly. There'll always be a balance of who God is. And not only that, I just feel the weight of the Holy Spirit with this. You know, the day will be, you know, will come that we're going to see amazing, how many Holy Spirit, I can't explain it. It's like you know, that there will be a wave of the love of God in those who are the remnant of Him. And I believe personally that yes, we should love everybody, but we gotta hate their sin. Because their sin is hurting God. And that God wants them to be set free. And here what's the evangelist Miguel going to say this? Jesus Christ came and died for your sin. He loved you to the point that he wanted to be set free from the drug addiction, from depression, from oppression, from cutting yourself, doing harm for yourself, being homeless. To take away your pain. I'm here to tell you that God wants you to be set free today. So if you're ready, I'm ready. If you want Jesus in your life right now, say this: Lord, I repent of my sins. Lord, I acknowledge that I am a sinner. And Lord, I believe that you died for me at the cross. And I believe your gospel, Lord, that you came and set me free today. So, Lord, I surrender my life to you. Lord, I am hungry for you, Lord. Change me, humble me, help me, Lord, to walk in your ways. Wash me clean by your blood. Lord, help me to be a new creation in you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Say that prayer by faith. Dude, I believe that you are saved. There are some steps to this. Go ahead and get water baptized. Get yourself a Bible. not it's, you know, can get a NIV or an English Standard Version or whatever version that you are comfortable reading, especially the King James. Go ahead and start doing your Bible readings every single day, and you start developing your prayer life. And I know for a fact that the Lord will gonna show you great things. And also get water baptized and get baptized in the Holy Ghost. And yeah, so that's all I got for today, folks. I hope you enjoy this sermon. I enjoyed the sermon. The Holy Spirit just in my heart, man. I don't know about you, but I know God's gonna be delivering some people through this church or through this ministry. And so I give God glory and praise in Jesus' name. All right. So I hope you guys have a great weekend, this Memorial Day weekend. And I'll see you guys again next time.